What's happening, folks, and welcome to an episode of Stars of Tomorrow, an FM20 series where we look at the young players on FM20, both players that I pick from my list and players that the subscribers and you guys suggest as well. And we see how they get on over the course of their career. Usually around the early 30s we usually go to on these reviews. Don't forget, guys, if you're enjoying this series, hit the like button to support it and subscribe if you're new to see more uploads from it. If you want to get involved, feel free down below to leave your player's suggestion. I would advise you look at the playlist and make sure he's not been done already, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. I would say also leave as much info on the player as you can, especially if he's in an obscure league, just so it's easy for me to find him on the database. So in case you're wondering, guys, where this has been, it's been lack of time to get these videos recorded. But on FM now, you've got daily uploads on FM. One day you get this series, next day you get the Wolves. You've got daily FIFA career mode and most likely daily Star Wars ones as well. A lot of content a day, but hopefully there's something for everyone there. I know from past experience, not every viewer watches every single video I do. So hopefully there's something there for everybody to watch, and hope you enjoy that. So, today's player is Jeremy Doku, a player I actually signed for Wolves. Spoiler alert. So this is the review being done after I've already signed him, or done the deal for him. So I'm going to see how he gets on this year. Last year he was very good last year. 17 years old, Belgian, left winger and striker. You can play him either role. The finish is a bit low for striker, but again, you can work on that. Main attribute here is his pace, 16 acceleration and pace. Tries tricks, beats man repeatedly. So, leaning more towards a winger player. Issue is he's got a left foot that is his best foot. He's then weak on his right foot. So bear that in mind. So currently he's been there a couple of seasons now. His contract was signed last year, so you could get him. Obviously, check out my series on Wolves, see how much I pay for him. Obviously, I'm not signing at the start of the game, first window, so that price may vary. But yeah, let's go forward, guys, first jump and see how he gets on early on. So folks, he's still at Anderlecht and worth £13.5 million. And straight away, crossing gone up to 15, dribbling up to 15, first touch 16, technique 16, and the pace is, again, the main attribute in him. I think the same last year won it as well. Still looking at his left foot and right foot, it's still the same. The player traits are exactly the same as well. Injury record, let's have a look here. One serious injury for 3 months from a hip injury in a match. So, you know, that's unfortunate. How has he got on in the time we've been looking at him? So first season got 5 goals, 3 assists. Then got 2 goals. Then got 5 and 2. So not great, but the stats are there, though. He's definitely a winger, and the pace is there. So he's not the most technical gifted player on the planet. He's not at the moment. We're £13.5 million. Contract information, he's got a £23 million release clause. So that could be something you have to be aware of for continental clubs. So bear that in mind if you look at signing him, that they may insert that in your game as well. So let's go forward again. Let's get going, because I want to see if he moves somewhere. Well, folks, he's gone to Lazio. We're £41.5 million. And he's basically the same, apart from technique up to 17. We've got some more player traits, though. We've got kicks the ball, knocks the ball past opponents, tries tricks, so only one more extra one. Slow your voice down a minute. So, injuries. Let's look at those. Okay. But then again, at a glancing view, take out the ones that are dazed, and it's not too bad. So, 2 serious injuries there. Food poisoning. Was one. God, for God's sake, I thought it was out for 2 months from food poisoning. That was in serious bad fish if he's... God's sake. Torn ligaments. Food poisoning. Tell ya. Stop eating, like, sushi and shit, mate, bro. It's just not good. It's not good for you, see? So let's have a look at how he got on. So, he went... From Anderlecht, he got 5 goals every season, practically. Moved AC Milan for £19.5 million. Not expensive at all. And got 5 goals, 2 assists in his first season. Then he got 6 and 4, moves to Lazio for 16.75, and gets 13 goals. Where are they playing him, though? Okay, striker in that season. So, interesting. Are they paying him as striker? They pay him as a... Okay, that's a FIFA formation I used to use last year with more of a cam, not a DM. They've got Fred. Okay. Fair enough. My United fans curious. Interesting. Let's continue. This is... I want to see how he does it last year, because 13 goals is highest he's ever got. I want to see if that continues. Well, folks, he's definitely increasing now at the bigger club. We've got 16 corners, 16 dribbling, 16 first touch, 17 technique. Good position and determination. Pace is still right in the area it was before. Player traits are still exactly the same, which is good to see. Injuries, not a serious injury since his torn knee ligaments, which is good. Again, not that injury prone, apart from one or two serious ones. So let's have a look at Lazio. First season he got 13, then he got 10, then he got 10 again, 17 that season, and then 10. So, we're seeing goals in this guy. The pace, I do feel like he could be a striker, but the finishing is a bit low for me. But again, you can work on that yourself. He's got a transfer range to PSG. End of contract. Okay. Interesting. End of contract, he's going to PSG. Let's see how that plays out for him. Well, folks, he's not at PSG anymore. He's not in Kansas either. Sorry, I had to. Pace gone down at 32 years old. We expected that, worth £29 million. This guy is good on the budget. I'll say that now. So we'll look at injuries. Okay, a couple more injuries, but again, age could be a factor in that, couldn't it? There's one here, look, for 4 months and 4 months there. So we'll look at career stats. So PSG signed for a free, didn't play him. Sold him £50 million to Real Madrid. Didn't do much that season. Next season, got 2 goals. So yeah, he should stay at Lazio. Is the honest truth about that. Interesting. The fees, I'm not ignoring the last bit. Early on, cheap. £19 million, £16 million. Buy him early. Develop him. The pace is there. Dribbling's there. Maybe get that fish at the 14 if you can. Maybe it would be ideal for me. But definitely worth having. I'm excited to have him in my team at Wolves. So I think he's definitely going to be somebody that we use in wide areas. I think the pace is very good. I would like his right foot to be better. Not sure how you're going to work on that. I may have to try and work on his right foot a bit. Not to make it like strong, but make it like reasonable. But we'll see, guys. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, folks. Next review, I've already got it planned, but you can also leave your suggestions down below. And I'll get to him as quick as I can. Like I said, it's bi-daily. So today you're getting the Wolves. Today you're getting this episode. Tomorrow you get a Wolves episode. Then next day you get another episode from this series. And so on and so on and so on and so on and so on. Just to try and make sure everyone's got something they like to watch. And I'm recording a bit of variety. And not overloading myself on one game all the time. So thank you so much for watching, folks. I will see you in the next episode for another review. If you've enjoyed this video, we'd love it if you hit the like button. And if you're new and you want to see more of these reviews, hit the subscribe button as well. We've got plenty more views to look at already, and there's some more coming as well. But until next episode, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye. Oh, I'm on the side.